The Rodecaster 2 has a ton of built-in features, but its fun functionality can be expanded when you connect it to a computer or a mobile device. So that's what we're going to talk about today. But before we get started, I want to remind you that I am using beta firmware on the Rodecaster Pro 2 right now. So you beta believe there could be some changes between this and the actual release version. The best news is that if you're really eager to get going down the road to awesome audio, the Rodecaster Pro 2 is totally just a plug-and-play device for both Mac and PC. As soon as it's connected to your computer, you will see it become an available input/output device. So here's my audio in Ecamm Live, but this will be the same for basically any application or interface. If I click on that, you can see Rodecaster Pro 2 Main and Rodecaster Pro 2 Chat, and we will chat all about that a little bit later. The same is true for output, so I'm just using Ecamm as the example, but if I go into my Ecamm preferences and I go to audio, my speakers again can be set to the Rodecaster Pro 2 as well. So you can use it as both an input and an output device just as soon as you connect it to your computer. This means if you want to use it with like Zoom calls or streams or anything like that, it's just plug and play. Same is true for the original Rodecaster Pro, and I've been using it that way for many, many years. Now, as is the case with pretty much any Rode product that you connect to your computer, the Rode Central app is central to some of the functionality. And again, this is a beta version, so some things might look different, but right here I can click on Rodecaster Pro 2 and we've got audio set up. This mirrors a lot of what is on the actual physical Rodecaster Pro, where I can rearrange my channel order, what's virtual, what's physical, all that functionality. Through here I can also do some basic configuration like the display brightness. I have a bunch of flexibility over output controls, and I also have some system settings as well, specifically this one right here, MIDI control, which we are going to talk about later because it's pretty exciting. You can customize your smart pads here. I'm not going to click continue right now since I am recording on the Rodecaster. Well, actually, I think I'll need to stop recording just to double check this. So I'm going to stop recording on the Rodecaster. Now you're listening to just my built-in shotgun microphone, but that's okay because I can show you a few important things here. If I click on customize smart pads, it's going to put the Rodecaster Pro into transfer mode. And on the display here, you will see it's in transfer mode. This is where I can adjust some of the settings, change the colors of the pads, go through pages of the pads, and through the Rode Central app is also where I can transfer recordings. This has been hugely beefed up from the Rodecaster Pro 1, and it's really exciting to me. For example, here's the recording that is the start of this video. As you can see, I have some basic editing functionality built in. I can also add markers. I can see all of my recordings here. I can even color code my recordings, which is really cool. I have the same presets that I had before. So if you know, like I use Buzzsprout, I want to upload my podcast audio to Buzzsprout directly, I can do that and it's gonna optimize it for that specific service. We can also choose our format here, sample rate, and you can even normalize the loudness. So if you wanna be negative 16 LUFS, you can just do it right there, and I LUF that feature. And one really cool thing that I was so excited to see is when the Rodecaster Pro 2 is in transfer mode, you can still play audio through it. So previously with the Rodecaster Pro 1, whenever I put it in transfer mode, it would just stop all audio coming in and out of it. So if I was listening to a podcast or music or something else and I transferred audio, that would just come grinding to a halt and wouldn't work until the Rodecaster Pro was out of transfer mode. Now, even though the screen says it's in transfer mode, if I have audio playing through it, it will continue to play while the Rodecaster Pro 2 is in transfer mode. Another thing that's delightful is the built-in micro SD card slot has a built-in card reader that's incredibly fast. So transfer speeds are much, much faster than the original. I don't have exact benchmarks because there are so many variables with that, but even if you're doing a multi-track file, you're not going to be sitting around waiting and waiting and waiting for your whole show to transfer in. And now I'm back recording on the Rodecaster Pro 2. So the Rode Central app, a really big thing to point out is while you can do a lot with the Rodecaster there and it's super easy to use, basically everything you can do there, you can do directly in the Rodecaster Pro 2 itself. It's much more of a standalone unit where you could potentially never even need to connect it to a computer if you don't want at all. But you do have a lot of flexibility and functionality if you do connect it. I definitely leave mine connected all the time because it's my main audio input/output interface. The Rode Central app is also where you can install firmware updates, but if you don't want to do that, you can just use the Rodecaster Pro 2's built-in Wi-Fi and just do them over the air, and it just works really well. You could also use the built-in Ethernet port for that as well, which is important to remember. So now let's take a minute and talk about MIDI functionality on the Rodecaster Pro 2, and admittedly, my MIDI knowledge is a little bit mini. So I'm gonna do my best to showcase and explain some things. So as we've talked about before, when it comes to the smart pads, you can assign MIDI functionality to them. You can assign them as triggers, actions, all that kind of stuff, which means the possibilities are endless when it comes to the potential there. But a really cool feature is the ability to use the Rodecaster Pro to control a DAW, a digital audio workstation. So within the Rode Central app or the Rodecaster Pro itself, that's where we can go to system, click on MIDI, and make sure that MIDI control is turned on. And that's going to make sure you can use the physical controls on the Rodecaster Pro 2 to control stuff within your computer. So I think the most logical thing for me to do right now is open up Logic Pro. Now I have a blank project file, but if we go down here to channel one right here, you notice that I'm recording into the Rodecaster right now. I'm going into channel one on the Rodecaster Pro and my fader is up, and that's where my level from this Procaster microphone is coming from. But I've got fader two set to control the volume within Logic over here. So you can see when I slide this, the fader there corresponds with my action perfectly. And my audio is still coming through channel one on the Rodecaster Pro. You can see my audio levels popping up there in Logic as well. I've also, just for the sake of example, taken the headphone two knob, this green knob right here, and I've had that set to adjust my panning in Logic on this specific channel. So basically you can take any of the physical functionality of the Rodecaster Pro and have that control software functionality in your DAW, which is just flat out dawesome. In fact, you might say that it blows my mind.
Remember the sound effects from the other day? I programmed those to some smart pads.
Whoa!
Anyway, back to business.
I will close out this project and start a brand new one. Now, I'm just using Logic for this example because I'm such a logical person, but of course you could do this with something like GarageBand, Pro Tools, whatever your DAW of choice happens to be. We are just gonna do an audio track. I'm just gonna make 5 tracks just for the sake of this example. And then I'm gonna press X on my keyboard to bring up the mixer interface within Logic Pro. Now within Logic Pro, I do have the Rodecaster set as my main input and output device. So as soon as I created this, whichever one of these channels I go onto, you see the Rodecaster's audio being used for that channel at that moment. So there are a few different ways that you can program MIDI functions. One of the simplest ones within Logic is to just press Shift Option K. And then it's going to bring up this controller assignment window. There's an easy view and an expert view. Even though I'm no expert, I use the expert view. And then you just click on learn mode. And basically from here, I can just click on what I want to teach and then start using a fader with that. And then click learn mode when I'm done. And now I've got channel 2, fader 2 on the Rodecaster Pro 2 set to channel 1, but I've still got channel 1 on the Rodecaster Pro 2 controlling the actual input for my microphone. So it's currently functioning both as a regular interface for my mic, but also as a MIDI controller for Logic Pro. If I want to make the volume knob control pan options, I just click on learn mode, click on the pan control, and then turn the knob that I want it to use, unclick learn mode, and there we go. And as I mentioned in my initial walkthrough video, you do have 8 pages of smart pads. So this is page 1 for me, which is mostly just sound effects like, you know, why did the bicycle fall over? It was too tired. And of course, my
amazing voice effects that are totally
mind-blowing.
But I can also go over here to page 2. I've got a bunch of empty settings. So if I go into the smart pad options, I can click the plus and you'll notice there's MIDI trigger right there. So I can go in here and now start configuring MIDI functionality to the smart pads directly from within the Rodecaster Pro 2 or from within the Rode Central app. Now, while we're talking about different ways to add inputs into your computer, there is something I forgot to mention in my initial walkthrough video, which if you haven't seen that yet, I highly recommend it because it kind of shows all of the physical functionality, or at least a lot of the physical functionality of the Rodecaster Pro 2. But to show you this, I'm going to stop recording there, back on the shotgun microphone, and now I'm going to go into the menu and go to faders. So now either from the Rodecaster Pro 2 or from within the Rode Connect app, I can make these changes here, and you see whatever I change on the app changes on the actual Rodecaster Pro 2 itself. If there's something I don't want, like I don't need channel 4 or channel 3, I can just get rid of those. And then on the home screen here, you'll see those are just blank, but I can click the plus and then add things back to them. Now here's something that you might run into. If you have a sweet keyboard or synthesizer or some kind of instrument or peripheral that has stereo outputs, you can use that with the Rodecaster Pro 2. So what you do is you go into your fader options. There's a little thing that says stereo below inputs 1 and 2, 2 and 3, and 3 and 4. And if I tap on that, what that's going to do is actually link those two inputs together and create a stereo pair. And a stereo pair is very different than a frightening nanny, which is a scary O pair. Wait, there it is. And now right here, you'll see I have channels 3 and 4 going into fader 3. So if I had a left and a right input plugged into channel 3 and channel 4, both of those are going into just this one fader that I'm controlling them with. And of course, I also have full pan left right functionality, which I guess would just defeat the purpose of creating a stereo linked pair. But hey, you've got all kinds of functionality built in here. Now we're also back to recording on the Rodecaster Pro 2, which means you couldn't hear the rim shot when I did the rim shot after my stupid au pair joke. Let's take advantage now of exploring that second USB-C port on the back of the Rodecaster Pro 2. Basically, there are essentially two interfaces inside this one Rodecaster Pro 2. Maybe that's what the 2 stands for. It doesn't, but it could, because there's two of them. So what that means is, while I'm connected to this computer, I can also be connected to something else. Fortunately, as the content-creating millennial that I am, I have a MacBook Pro right here. So now I will connect the Rodecaster to the MacBook. So now, just for an example, I've opened up Zoom and I've gone to the audio settings. And right here, you can see as soon as I connected the Rodecaster Pro 2, it says Rodecaster Pro 2 secondary. So there is a primary and a secondary USB output. So right now I've got two computers connected to the Rodecaster Pro 2 and I am recording into it here. This one is my Rodecaster Pro 2 secondary computer. My Mac Mini is my Rodecaster Pro 2 main computer, but that's not it. So just with that setup, basically, any of the audio that's coming from the Mac Mini through the first input can go into the Rodecaster on USB 1, and any of the audio that's coming from the second computer will go on USB 2. So now what I can do, since I don't have any friends at the moment to chat with, so sad, is I can set my output on my computer to the Rodecaster Pro 2 chat. And now if I play some beautiful Artlist royalty-free music, you can hear that on my chat channel. And I can turn it up or down with this knob right here. I could also make that a physical channel if I don't want it to be a virtual channel. But the benefit of being able to do that is I can now have two inputs to the Rodecaster from one single computer source, which means I can have my main USB sending whatever signals I want. And then I can also have the chat channel, which in this case I was using for music, but it could be a chat. And then that can also be a USB mix minus situation. So if you want to be able to hear people in a chat, but you don't want to like have the infinite loop going back, you can turn on USB mix minus. You can drop that out. There we go. My XLR cable is going bad. So if you're hearing weird fuzz or anything throughout this video, it's the cable. It's not the Rodecaster Pro 2. I need those new Rode colorful cables. Hey. All of them. I need all of them. So what this means is now you can have two USB inputs from your main computer. You can have the chat and then the main. And while that's listed as chat, I think that there's a ton of flexibility in there, as you can probably see, for routing all kinds of audio, dual audio from a single computer source into the Rodecaster. And then we've also got our secondary computer source. We can also connect something like a phone via Bluetooth. And then of course we've got our other microphone and instrument inputs. That's a lot of different stuff. But even that is not all. If I unplug my secondary computer here and I don't need this anymore, I have that secondary USB port. And now I can connect an SSD, which is SSD lightful because now I can record here in addition to my memory card, in addition to a DAW. But as soon as I connected it right up here at the very top, it popped up with USB and it says I have 12 plus hours of recording time. So I'm gonna stop again. Stopped recording on the Rodecaster Pro just so I can go into these settings and sort of show you. So now that you're just listening to the shotgun mic again, if I tap on these icons for the SD card and the SSD, it will bring up my storage screen, which will then show me what I have. So I have 61 gigs on my SD card left, 781 gigs on my USB SSD left. I can eject those right here, and I can also turn them on or off. So I can choose which one I want to record to at any given time or both simultaneously. And notice I didn't have to format this drive before using it. I can format it if I want, but since I already have a lot of files on here and I just want to quickly connect it to the Rodecaster and add a show because maybe I forgot an SD card or something, or I just want extra redundancy, I can do that without having to lose what's already on here. And then I can just connect this to my computer and drag the files over. And now we're back to recording on the Rodecaster Pro. And while I'm recording and starting and stopping throughout this video, I think it's important to mention you do have the same functionality as the original, where if I hold down the record button, it will turn orange after a few seconds and recording is paused. So now I'm using a different microphone. And as soon as I tap it again, recording will resume and I can pick up back here. But on top of that, you can do the same thing just by tapping the record icon on the display itself. So you have multiple ways to actually start and stop recording, which is very, very fun. And you might have seen this QR code that's on the front of the Rodecaster Pro 2 and wondered what it's all about. Basically, if you get stuck with any of this stuff because there's so much, you can just use that QR code to go directly to the information and support guide, which is actually very, very helpful. It's very nice that QR code can come to the rescue. Speaking of things that come to the rescue, thank you to everyone who helps support my channel through Patreon and YouTube channel memberships. And if you haven't yet seen it, please be sure to check out my initial walkthrough of the Rodecaster Pro 2 to see all of the awesome things it can do for you.